Hello, my name's Lewis Houghton, and I'm playing Athel in A Slow Air.
My name's Polly Knowles. I'm playing Morna in A Slow Air.
He's from Edinburgh originally, but he lives in a wee town outside Glasgow called Houston, where he moved to from Glasgow. He lives with his wife Evelyn. He's got two kids who are up and away. Athel runs a floor tiling company. And he's less forthright, shall we say, than Morna. More staid, more outwardly solid, but there's a fire burning inside of him as well. Suddenly it's past 11 and Evelyn says, "You can stay the night if you want, Josh." "That'd be great," he says. When he was out of the room, Evelyn looks at me and says, "Have you asked him how Morna is?"
I relate to Athel. I remember first speaking to David about this when he first sent me his very first draft of it. I just said, "Yeah, I need to play that character. I know that man." Now, I probably know him because there's a lot of me in him, but that's maybe not a good thing. So I know him through other people as well. I recognise Athel. I recognise Athel as a Scottish man with his insecurities. I recognise him, the age that he is, and where he grew up and how he grew up. Yeah.
Give you the basics. She's a single mother in her early 40s, lives in Edinburgh. Her son is called Joshua and he's about to turn 21. I would say she's a kind of strong, forthright kind of person. She likes to have fun. I don't think she takes herself or life too seriously, but she's had her problems in the past. And I know he sees a few other women, but you can't pretend to be better than me in the whole world.
Different people in families have different aspirations, different goals. I think parents drive that. And I think siblings or sons and daughters can often either, at various times, can often go with their parents. You know, they think that everything their parents say says gospel, or they can totally rebel against that, and I think that's the kind of position we have with Morna and Athel. Athel obviously doted on his parents and kind of agreed with them philosophically, whereas Morna was the complete opposite and kind of rebelled. So, and I think that's part of the divisions between Morna and Athel.
I've got quite a large family. Everyone has, you think you're all having the same experience, but the older we get, I think the more we realise that we're all individuals in that family, and we've made decisions about our lives, either as a reaction to decisions that other siblings have made, or in isolation, I think, you know. And I think in Morna's case, it's very definitely her decisions are about a rejection of what her family kind of circumstances, how she was brought up.
Hopefully, everyone in the audience will have, well, actually I know for a fact because I've done it before, but they'll all have a similar experience. Every family's got a story like this. So just on a familial level, just on the person-to-person level, they'll have had an experience like this, or they know someone very close that's going through something like that. New people have come up to me previously with tears in their eyes, people you never thought could have managed a tear, talking about casting directors and things, say, "I haven't spoken to my sister for 12 years, I'm just going to go and phone her," and things like that. You know, so I think there's a lot of that happens. Folk have a shared experience and because it's something they identify with. I've worked for Borderline once before. We did a tour of a play called The Angel's Share with Chris Dolan. And I had a wonderful time doing that. And so it's good to be back. It was a good crowd.
I have never worked with borderline before, but very happy to, and I'm happy to see that there's something, there's life again back down here, theatrically, you know, artistically. It's just encouraging. It's encouraging to hear and to be part of something that's still going, and particularly, you know, a piece of this quality.